So once again, hello guys, and welcome back to our course about how to build an awesome clothing brand. So congratulations, until now you have completed all that you need to know to be able to create your clothing brand. You know, you already have your Shopify account, you know how works the clothing industry, and how to launch your business, how to create a successful business plan, you know what app to use, and what products you will sell. So today's course will be more technical. We're gonna talk about how to create a great homepage and how to create a great store in general. And next classes will add some more advanced features. So let's start. So first thing, you wanna go on your homepage. You will land on your homepage, click on online store, and then simply customize your theme. So just click on your online store to land you up on this page. And you just click on customize. So for this course, we're gonna use one of my stores as an example. It's a clothing brand. So the first thing you wanna do is you should right now have your logo. I suggest you to use, for the colors, I suggest you to use colors that are not too flashy but not too dark at the same time. So something like black or white or gray as background color. Me, I personally like white. It can be beautiful. So the first thing we want to do is we want to add a logo. So how do we add our logo right here? It's very simple. We just go on header and here logo image. We just click on add logo image. For me, I have a change, but you will click on add. That's it. This will create your, well, this will add your logo. So I really suggest you to have a logo before opening up your store. Second thing, we want to create a slideshow right here. So a slideshow with at least 2 to 4 images. So me, I have 4. So how we create a slideshow? Very easy. Usually here, you can create whatever you want. So simply click on add the section and look for slideshow. So the slideshow is just here next to image. Simply click on slideshow and the slideshow will be automatically generated. When the slideshow is created, so we're going to create the slideshow together once again. So let's say you create your slideshow. Where can you find all the pictures? Very simple. You'll simply, well, first image slide. You'll explore the free image gallery of Shopify. So they offer you images that are not copyrighted, so you will be able to take them. So let's say we want something that is with clothing, that has with clothing. You just click on clothing and we can have access to hundreds of general photos that we can use. If you want more specific photos, pictures, it's also possible, but for this you'll have to upload them. So let's say you're making a website about vacation clothing. You can put on vacation pictures. So let's say, for example, this one here, which is a beautiful picture about traveling. So it represents traveling. If you create a brand more a city brand or something that people will wear in the nightlife, can have pictures more about city, so city night, and create something around really the nightlife. So as you can see, they offer you hundreds and hundreds of pictures for you to use. If you can't find the right picture here, I can suggest you another place where you can find your pictures. It's called Pixel. So it's gonna be, just look for Pixel on Google, it's gonna be the first one here. So all the pictures that you have here and all the videos, if you wanna add a video, for example, on your website, are all free of copyright. So let's say you wanna look for a video about traveling. So you'll have hundreds of videos about traveling that you can download without even creating an account, and you can put them directly on your website. well on your e-commerce. So as you can see, it's very, very simple to create. The second thing we want to do is create your collections, well, your featured collections that you're gonna use for your homepage. Here I have my collections that I call feature, well, the featured collection, things that I want to sell, so the things that are for sale and I want them to be sold. Usually I put them all in the main menu collection. I put them all here. So it's very simple. You choose the products that you want for sale now and just drag them into the main menu. In the tags of the products, you'll simply add the main menu and will automatically put your products in the collection of main menu. So, well, homepage or main menu, same thing. So the way you want to present this, so you will have your first image here, your first slideshow. Then the second thing, you will have your featured collections. I suggest 2 to 3 rows max. I have 3 rows. So this is how it's supposed to be presented. Don't put too much text on your homepage. You want people to look at your products, not start reading all the text that you have. So really go straight to the products so people can see the products. Last thing, if you want to add a text or something, here for example I have an affiliate program that we're going to talk about it later, how you can create your own affiliate program. You can add it at the end of the page. So once again, don't write too much text all over your homepage, because people will not be interested in just reading a lot of text. So to summarize, once again, logo right here, slideshow here, then your featured collection, and then if you want to add text, well, you can add your text down here. After that, for the presentation, second thing, you have your catalog. Me personally, I have a catalog. If you want, you can put on, let's say, men, women, and then accessories. Me, I have just a catalog. I divide it this way. So you divide men and women. You don't sell, if you sell products for both of them, well, you can just put on shirt, t-shirt, or whatever. Me, I have products for men, for women. So let's say we're going to click on shirt. The way you want to present your products, you don't want to create too much variation. So let's say, for example, this product is the same product. The only difference is that the shirt is different. But I will not... Well, let me show you. So here, for example, the only thing that I will have, the only variation that I will have will be sizes. But it will never be colors. For example, I will not have this t-shirt in red, in blue, in white, in green at the same place. Let me give you an example of a mistake. So this t-shirt, for example, is definitely something you don't want to do because you have too much choice. When the consumer has too much choice, it's too much is like not enough. You don't want to give too much choice, because if the consumer once again has too much choice, he will be hesitant to buy the product. So don't put this little thing here. Well, you can put it if you give to the consumer maybe 2 or 3 choices, but it's better for you to just add all the products. For example, here I have this t-shirt in black, here I have it in white. Same thing for the shirts here. So here I have it in pink, here I have it in blue-green. Same thing. Exactly the same thing for women. So as you can see, don't put too much choice of color when you click on a product. So as you can see here, I have 4 products. 4 products here, 4 products here. There is no, I don't put too much choices, because too much, as I said, is like not enough. And the way you want to present your product, you want something that is geometrically beautiful to look at. If all the pictures are different, well, it's not gonna be very, very beautiful. For example, let's say here I use the same model, but if in all the pictures I had a different model, well, the presentation of the website will not be that great. For example, let me show you something that is not really, really great. For example, the homepage. As you can see here, this image, well, it's not the same model here, it's not the same model here, it's not the same model here. So as you can see, it's not as beautiful, or it's not as presentable as here, where all my models are the same. So this page is more beautiful to look at. After that, the last thing you want to have is your affiliate, but the affiliate, we're going to talk about it in our more advanced features. Same thing when we talk about the currency converter or the language changer. That's those are things you want to add on your website a bit later. We're going to talk about it in our next class about the more advanced features. So see you guys in the next class.